Very shallow reefs have a flat top, like this one here. Hard corals grow up towards the sun, but can't grow beyond the low tide mark. These shallow growing corals need permanently calm water like you find in protected bays with no chance of wave action. These are important habitats for some juvenile reef fish, but unfortunately, these are the same areas that humans choose for settlement and resorts. This is another protected bay ecosystem, though not as shallow, which explains the lower light levels and bigger fish. These inshore habitats are often hit with heavy silt runoff during monsoon rains, and only certain coral species can survive. The dominant species we usually find is this Parietes finger coral, which is a great fish habitat with lots of different size nooks and crannies for the fish to hide in and hunt from. This is a more exposed reef out in a channel in the Solomon Islands. Better water quality flushing through means you get good hard coral diversity, even down around 15 metres, 50 feet. There's some coral rubble which you can see off to the lower right. That's probably storm damage from years or even decades ago, where the fast-growing species, which aren't as robust, such as plate and staghorn corals, get smashed up by a serious wave action. The rubble slowly gets encrusted and glued together by sponges and coralline algae, which makes a solid substrate that the new corals can colonise, which starts the whole process again. The spiky dark green structure is a hard coral called tubastria, and the orange fish are female threadfin anthias. The males are the pale purple with yellow tail and red stripe under the eye. There are two groups of maybe 30 or 40 female anthias for each of the two males. This is the leading edge of a semi-exposed reef. You can see the wall off to the right, and it's always hard to find somewhere to position a tripod for this shooting angle back toward the reef. But this is exactly where most of the action is when the current's running, as it is here. This current brings the plankton, and all of these fish are planktivores. We've got anthias, damsels and fusiliers here. They all want to swim out into blue water to catch plankton ahead of the competition, but not too far out that they might get eaten themselves by the blue water predators. The further out they swim, the longer it takes them to dash back to the protection of the reef. So fusiliers are faster than damsels, which is why they're out a bit further. Damsels are faster than anthias, or maybe they're just a bit more daring.